Okay, I'd like to look at a nice simple problem here. It's an oscillation problem. In this case, what do I have? I have a mass on a spring. So I've got this spring here, just like that. And then I'm going to hook up a mass to it. So this is at one level, we'll call that zero. And then I'm going to hook up a mass to it. And it's going to come down here. And that mass is 4 kilograms. And it's that 4 kilograms stretches this. Okay, so it has to stretch down to the same spot. So if this is the place where the mass would hook at, right here, this is 20 centimeters. And then this thing oscillates with an amplitude of 5 centimeters. So this is 10 centimeters peak to peak, peak to peak, peak to peak. All right, and we want to know what its period is. All right, so we want to figure out how long it takes for it to go from here, down here, and then back again. All right, that's what we want to find out. So what do we know about this system that can help us find that? Well, we're given a mass or an object of mass. M is equal to 4 kilograms, looks like. And we have a spring, right, which gets stretched by a distance, let's call it delta x, or I guess this is in up and down, so we'll call it delta z, all right. And that's stretched by a distance of 20 centimeters, and it oscillates. And it's got an amplitude, A is equal to 5 centimeters, all right? And what we want to do is we want to find the oscillation period. We want to find the period of oscillation. And we call that T, all right? Concept, this is simple harmonic motion. Equation, what's a good equation for this? How about the frequency of a simple harmonic oscillator, which is root K over M? Okay. So that's what we have to work with, and now we want to get an answer. Let's see. We don't know K, we know M, we want to know omega, so we have to find some way to find K. The way I'd probably do that is with a nice free body diagram. So I've got some weight coming down here. I've got a spring force coming up here, and they balance out at 20 centimeters, right? So so that would mean the spring force is minus K delta Y. This is what I want, and this I have, or Z, let's call it delta Z. So I've got this. I want that. A weight is equal to mg. This is a universal constant. I know g, I know m. So that should be good. I know all those things. I can balance things out. So one, find k from the stretching. From that, I should be able to use this equation. Right? So in this case, I'm saying that this has to balance that, so mg is equal to k delta z, meaning k is equal to mg over delta z. And that's a number we could find. It wouldn't mean much because we're going to use all this stuff later anyway, so why bother? All right, so let's go ahead and find the period, or find the frequency, right? So the frequency is omega is equal to root k over m, right? Which is equal to the root of mg over delta z over m, right? So that's just z over delta z. And we're almost there. We need the period, right? Not the, not the frequency. But of course, the period is just, so we can get a little more room, is equal to 2 pi over omega, right? Period is 2 pi over the frequency. It's the inverse of the frequency. So that's equal to 2 pi times delta z over g instead, is equal to 2 pi times delta z is 20 centimeters and g is 9.8 meters per second squared. So that's 0.2 meters. If I do all this together, that's 2 pi root 49, it looks like, seconds, which is approximately about 44 seconds. Okay, so that's what our period is. We've done all this work. We've kept our units and all that good stuff. So, I mean, that the period is in seconds is good. Periods are times, so that's what we want. Let's see, anything else good for us? Anything special about 44 seconds? It's pretty long. It's a pretty long period. I don't know if I'd normally trust that if I was actually using data. There are things with periods much longer than that, but still, usually 44 seconds, as far as a spring system like this is concerned, that might be a little bit much in general. Again, there are plenty of systems with low K or large M, so it's completely possible. So that's it. Nice, simple, to the point. I hope you loved it as much as I loved it, and I'll see you in class.